tinnitus is a perception of phantom sound when there's no sound in the environment. It could be ringing, it could be tonal at one pitch, or it could be broadband, like noise, or it could be rolling, hissing. It can vary from day to day, and even the intensity can vary. And there are secondary symptoms. Sometimes it's associated with anxiety and depression. You don't really need diagnosis, because if you have it, you know it. But if you suddenly develop a tinnitus, you should see a doctor to rule out certain possibilities, for example, brain tumors, a stroke, microstroke, or vascular disorders. There's not a FDA-approved effective treatment yet, but we don't have to lose hope, because there are many ways we can manage the impact of tinnitus. And there are also many ways people are trying, many experimental methods to treat tinnitus, to eliminate tinnitus. People have known for a long time the hearing loss, which is the biggest risk factor for tinnitus, is associated with neuroinflammation in the brain auditory pathway. And many of the risk factors are also associated with neuroinflammation. So all these things prompted us to hypothesize that neuroinflammation might be the common pathway for all the risk factors to influence the likelihood of tinnitus. Now there's a clinical trial going on testing pro-inflammatory cytokine blockers for treatment of tinnitus. We see a gap between neuroinflammation and the perception of phantom sound. We want to know what happens in between, so the mechanisms from neuroinflammation to tinnitus. And we hope that studying these mechanisms will give us better target for treatment of tinnitus.